Hey guys, HDV here, and welcome to a brand new video. Today we have a pretty interesting rumor to cover about the alleged Pokemon Diamond and Pearl remakes apparently coming out next year for the 25th anniversary. Now it's interesting because this rumor apparently has got some information within it that is true, according to a technical reliable source on Twitter. Either way, it's an interesting one. But if you're excited for today's video, drop a like down below. It really does help out. Let's try and hit 500 likes. Make sure to drop a comment as well. What would you love to see next year? And subscribe if you're brand new. We do daily Pokemon content on this channel. With all of that out of the way though, let's get into the video. Really hope that you enjoy. So, starting things off, this is the information about the rumor. It was posted 11 days ago on Reddit, and basically, we all know about Eclipse, who is a Twitter user, which apparently knows some stuff that we don't. They've been posting riddles about the Diamond and Pearl remakes and the next games and everything like that. Again, we don't know if they are a credible source or not, but apparently they are. I don't know why, but some people are saying they are. I don't know. But basically, there was a rumor on 4chan which was fake, but a lot of the information within that rumor is apparently a correct guess according to Eclipse. So it's an interesting rumor. Let's jump into it and you'll see what I mean. So basically, it's titled DP Remake Leak with possibly some real information. So I wanted to make this post about this so people here were aware of this. So a few hours ago, Eclipse tweeted this. They say, since I'm feeling down, here, take note of this. 72 with a bunch of zeros after it. It's a good one I saw online, and I must say, nice guesses, Anna. And then this person says, there was a 4chan leak that started with that related, perhaps. Given the content, my personal hope is that it's fake. So a few hours ago, Eclipse tweeted that. The more interesting part, however, is how he says, nice guesses, Anon. The Anon part, along with the it's a good one I saw online, points to this being a 4chan leak. The intriguing part about this is that a bit under 24 hours ago now, a leak was posted on 4chan with the image simply being 72000000. Of course, this being a 72-day countdown to Pokemon Day. The number fits, so what does this mean? Well, there is a lot of information on this thread, but it doesn't seem to be all right. Eclipse specifically says nice guesses, which seems to imply that this is a fake leak that gets some information correct simply by chance. So this is the 4chan leak that they obviously are referencing to. It was posted on the Thursday, the 17th of December, posting now that I am free to do so without any issues. So apparently this is a fake rumor. But according to Eclipse, a lot of the information in this rumor is correct. Like, they've guessed correctly, which, you know, some rumors do. You know, obviously anyone can guess correctly. Like, anybody can make a rumor and say, oh, we're getting this and this and this and this. And then maybe some parts of it's true, some parts of it isn't. You're like, we kind of have an idea of what we're going to get. So it's not too difficult to be able to guess what it is going to be. But anyway, it says, now for the information in the leak. I've decided to list it in summary here to save you all from having to look through the relatively long thread, because it's a pretty long thread. So it says, Dynamax and G-Max return in Sinnoh. Less G-Maxes than Sword and Shield added. It says, DLC is planned to tie into the 2022 game with 9 new Pokemon in it, voted by fans. So I don't know if this vote has happened yet, or maybe they're going to be doing something about Pokemon of the Year. But of course, everything on this list, I mean, maybe none of it's true, but from what Eclipse is saying, some of this is true and some of it isn't. We don't know what isn't true. Again, Eclipse could just be faking it all and none of it could be true, but you know what I mean. This is why it's interesting, though. So the leaker details the starter's G-Max forms and moves. So basically, Infernape looks more like Sun Wukong with a flaming flying Nimbus, which is obviously what Goku has in Dragon Ball. The G-Max move is basically Dragon Fist from Dragon Ball, so very heavily inspired by Dragon Ball, but with an ape face instead. Torterra resembles a quadruped High Sea Gamera with a devastated shell top. I don't have a clue what that is. G-Max move sets up Leech Seed and Ingrain. Empoleon is more menacing, lean and bulky with a Harpoon Flipper. The G-Max move works like Flying Press but is Water Steel, as Empoleon summons a huge trident. So this again, could not be true. You know, we don't know. A lot of this is talking about G-Max forms, but again, a lot of it could not be. Like, there could be like two things here that are true and the rest not. Like, we don't know, but the fact that Eclipse specifically pointed this one out, I feel like a lot of like the main information should be true, because I'm guessing quite a few people have spoken about like the wild area, the Pal Park and everything like that, but this person has gone quite into detail about the Gen 4 starters getting Dynamax and Gigantamax forms, so maybe that is the true part. But anyway, it says other G-Max forms, no detail, just listed is Staraptor, Luxray, Rampardos, Bastiodon, Vespiquen, Pachirisu, Perugly, Skuntank, Spiritomb, Garchomp, Lucario, Weavile, Togekiss, Yanmega, Gliscor, Mamoswine, Ambipom, Crobat, Azumarill, Meganium, Typhlosion, and Feraligatr. So the Gen 2 starters also getting some luck. Now we can obviously see here that it is a majority of Sinnoh Pokemon. The only Gen 2 Pokemon here are Crobat, Azumarill, Meganium, Typhlosion, and Feraligatr. So interesting why they get Gigantamax forms and no other generations do. But it says the DLC will be set in the Sinjar Ruins with Johto specific Pokemon, leading to a closed city setting up the 2022 games. A new universe being set up called Kapumon by the leaker supposedly uses scrapped GS beta designs but modernized, will be an AU of the first five gens, therefore being in a different continuity from Gen 6 and beyond. According to the leaker, Ultra Beasts come from the same universe. That's the thing about Ultra Beasts. You can literally put them in any game because they can just open up a little warp hole and be like, hello, and they can just zoom in. So, yeah, that's always interesting. It says the wild area will be situated around the Floroma Town / Valley Windworks / Eterna Forest area. That's an interesting one because it's not like a massive area. Then it says Pal Park used like Friend Safari from Gen 6. It'd be really cool to get the Friend Safari back. The leaker says there will be a Gen 1 to 5 master collection of some kind, so Gen 1 to 3 as one, Gen 4 to 5 as another. Dawn Lucas have a modernized redesign. Names are Primal Diamond and Evolved Pearl. That could be right, maybe that's what Eclipse is referencing, the names. It says the Sinnoh Dex until post-game, no regional variants. This is basically all he said. A lot of this information seems very unlikely, and some just straight up contradicts what Eclipse has hinted at in the past, most noticeably the titles, as they don't match what Eclipse seems to have hinted at as being DD and DP, meaning he wouldn't be endorsing that part. To me, it seems as if the leaker's correct guesses are the starters' Gigantamax designs and or the list of G-Max provided. But who knows? Maybe he got more things right. I'm not 100% sure what to think. Some of it sounds detailed and real, and some of it sounds completely fake. So by posting this, I'm also hoping to get some more opinions on what everyone else thinks is real and fake. So they basically say, Empoleon is more menacing, lean, and bulky with a Harpoon Flipper. Badass. New universe being set up named Kapumon by the leaker. This is what makes me think it's fake, though. I mean, the rumor is fake. Like, we don't know it's fake, but it is most likely fake. Eclipse has said that it was nice guesses, so some parts of this are just complete, like, BS. It says, yeah, that's way too cool and ambitious to come from Game Freak. Agreed. As I said, it seems like a lot of this info is fake, but if Eclipse is right, there's bound to be some gens in here waiting to be dug up. Let's hope those cool designs are one of them. DLC set in there, interesting. Leaker says there will be a Gen 1 5 Master Collection. Does Gen 5 mean Soul Silver also, or will that be in the Gen 2 collection? Well, Soul Silver is Gen 4. I hope to goodness that the Pokemon Company doesn't expect me to shell out money to be able to play the original Pokemon Silver when an upgraded version exists. What from Ruby Sapphire come in? I don't care. I remember them mentioning it would include all games of each generation. Specifically, they mentioned Ruby Sapphire and Emerald for Gen 3, so my guess will be Gold, Silver, and Crystal for Gen 2, but maybe Heart Gold and Soul Silver would come with Gen 4. Either that, or they just wouldn't include remakes, not sure. The D-Max stuff seems likely since Fire and Leaf Green and used the Ruby and Sapphire assets to make it. Heart Gold, Soul Silver use Diamond, Pearl, and Platinum, and most pressing, Auras uses the XY assets, all of which are used in the same battle engine, animations, and mechanics of their generation they were remade in, with Auras specifically using Megas. At this point, it would seem quicker and cheaper to copy and paste that from Sword and Shield instead of going through the trouble of deleting them. The rest is dodgy to me. The Gen 9 tie-in seems sketch, because it's best they'd hide a hint somewhere for it unless it's in a side game, which, as we've seen, are free tease what they want. DLC seems sketch to me too, because unless they plan on 2022 being a gap year like 2020 was, they want pretty much all hands on deck to work on whatever title or titles they plan to release next. I can see them revamping old capsule monsters that were cut. I'd especially love to see a certain skeleton monster from Gold Development and Warwolf. But what does the AU in this scenario mean? Another Gen 5 situation where they make a soft reboot to the franchise? Another counter reboot or remake? This reminds me of the PYUK rumors that said Gen 8 would be set in an area above a flooded pallet town or something. The Master Collection bit is one I see a lot more quite frequently. Rumors about it who haven't started it, Mario didn't have a 3D collection. It pops up now and then, and until Nintendo directly says they'll do it, I just don't see it happening. They like Pokemon products to be scarce, so they can sell remakes or VGC versions of games, which nets more money. Now, a master collection of the 3D console games pre-Gen 5, I can see that because it's going to be harder and harder to find working copies of Stadium 1 and 2, Colosseum NXD, and Battle Revolution without resorting to piracy. The other bubble to pop here is that Gen 4 and 5 are both DS games, and have a fair of their functionality tied into a second screen, so either they'd need to rework their UI to make it a single screen, or they'd have to try and tap into smartphones, or they'd just emulate it on the TV screen as well. And to be honest, that's just clunky. It seems way too much work from what they possibly want to bother with, and remakes would be quicker and more lucrative. The rest seems okay, not perfect, but okay. That's very true. I never even really thought about it. That's very true. So yeah, shout out to that guy. Absolutely smashed that comment. But anyway, that is going to be everything for today's rumors. An interesting one. But what do you guys think about it? Again, we don't know if Eclipse is even telling the truth. But if he is, then obviously some of this is apparently true. So an interesting rumor nonetheless. But thank you so much for watching today's video. If you did enjoy, please do drop a like down below. It really does help out. Let's try and hit 500 likes. Make sure to drop a comment as well. What do you think about this rumor/technical leak? Let me know, and subscribe if you're brand new. We do daily Pokemon content on this channel. That's everything from me though. Have a fantastic rest of your day. Until next time, peace.